Is that person that you're thinking about going on a date with real? Like, are they AI generated? What a bonkers time that we're living in, right? Where that is even possible. And have you seen this? Like, what AI is actually capable of generating? So this here is a Streamlit application. It's a Python framework. It's awesome for prototyping. I use it at hackathons and I like build internal tools. It's also great for exploring, which is exactly what I want to do because we, Cloudflare Workers AI, just released a bunch of models that I want to play with. And I know that playing is key to understanding what is possible. So I'm not on the dating apps, and I realize that I'm very lucky and I met my partner before these even existed, but I'm also pretty fascinated with the process, right? I'm super interested in the profile picture as an art form. I'll admit, I'm on the train sometimes, and I just watch people swiping just on the profile picture alone. It's got this really good feedback loop, and it makes me wonder, like, what is that? What would mine look like? Like, if I had to make one of these, what would these look like? So I love hearing dating stories, and I talk to my friends, and I say, what is it like? What do you see? What are men doing that you see here? And one of the things that always comes up, which kind of is mind-boggling, I'm not exactly sure why this happens, but they say that there's a lot of photos of men holding fish. So I was thinking, why don't we create a little fake profile photo here of that? So I'm gonna do that. I'm using these. This is the Stable Diffusion. We've got this Dream Shaper. What I'm gonna keep in here. This is also a Stable Diffusion model. And what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna say an attractive man. We want him to be attractive, right? Otherwise, what's the point, right? An attractive man holding. Let's just do it. Holding a fish. What happens? So I'm gonna press generate. Now this is one of those things where I don't want you to do this at home. I want you to do this at home, but I don't want you to feel like you should use this on a dating app. I don't want that to happen. So this is an attractive man holding a fish. Pretty nice, right? That's pretty great. And while that was running, I also ran another text generation thing here based on an attractive man holding a fish. I said, what's a better prompt for that? And I'll show you how this all works. But here's some more. A captivating portrait of a well-groomed man glistening in a vibrant fish in a serene natural setting with a soft, warm color palette. Just stuff that you could use to make the photo more descriptive of what you wanted. Because our man came out, it looks like he's at an aquarium and maybe he stole a fish. I don't think that's probably not what we want. But we could fix that. We could change that later. Speaking of changing this later, I know that if I were to use this profile photo, I would probably get what I've heard happens. It's like, wow, you look nothing like your profile photo. And it's true. My eyes don't really look like that. So here's the thing that you could do, actually. I'm going to save this. I'm going to save this image into this man with fish. This is me with a fish into my dating site directory in case I start building some of these. I'm gonna go and I'm gonna stop and I'm gonna do the next model that I want to show off is a really cool one that lets us do what's known as masking. We can this is again another Streamlit app. I'm gonna upload my latest creation here, which was man with fish. Here we go. Here he is. He's gonna come in here. Now I can do this really cool thing where I can actually draw on this, and this is where Streamlit really comes in. This is a nice widget that's here. I can draw and I can say I want to replace these. Oh, man, those do not look like my eyes. Let's be realistic here. So I'm gonna say, what would you like to see replaced? I'd like to see my eyes replaced. And I'm gonna go ahead and generate that. And that's gonna go and it's gonna take my mask. That's called a mask that I put on there, and it's gonna put it up there. And that doesn't look the greatest, but I think that you could see that this is pretty awesome, right? This is a pretty awesome thing. I could replace pictures in here. I could take out these sharks in the background if I wanted to, replace it with something else. It's super powerful. Let's do that again. Let's fix those eyes. Instead of the eyes, why don't you know what? I've heard that the other popular thing is that people have like some sweet sunglasses, right? So we'll put on some cool sunglasses because I want to look hip, right? I want to look hip in my dating app. Let's see what happens. Ooh, those are cool. Look at that. You could get that better. If I drew that a little bit better, the mask would kind of be perfect for the shape of what I was trying to accomplish. We have another thing. So I can actually see how this does. So I'm gonna save this image. Let's keep on. We're gonna keep moving through different models here. We're gonna save this as a cool guy with fish, because I think that's the move I'm going for on these dating sites. So I'm gonna stop what we got running here. I'm gonna go to our next model, which is a vision API. I can actually see and ask questions about a picture. So I've got this running here. I'm going to open this up, and we want cool guy with fish is our what we're working on here. And by default, there's this question about the photo. I just want to show you what this does. So it's going to look at that photo. I've sent the photo up. I'm asking, describe what is happening in this photo. A young man is holding a large fish underwater. He is wearing glasses and a black tie. In the background, there's underwater rocks and fish. That is amazing that we can do that. I was told that we'd never be able to do that, and look what we're able to do. So what could you do with that? Like, that's pretty amazing. And you can ask it, like, really good questions. Like, I guess probably what you're thinking about as you're swiping is, like, would this man make a good partner? Like, that's what I'm wondering. Like, do I want to date this person? And let's see what happens. He seems to be a good partner. He's holding a large fish, which is a good size for a partner. I guess the size of the fish matters in this case. So I want you to do this. I want you to play with this. It's important for you to see what is possible. But if you don't mind, I'd like to show you actually like how possible this is. I'd like to show you the code. So let's dive in here really quick. I'm going to show you, this is the prompting model that we did. So this is what Streamlit looks like. So Streamlit is ST in this situation. And you just put out a string and it writes it on the screen. So that first one said prompting. Here's a select box. These are the different models that we have available. A really nice UI. I put in the prompt, I get it back. I'm pulling out my Cloudflare account ID and my API token, because that's all that I need to do to run this model. I'm not even running this in workers. I'm just going to hit the API. So I'm going to do a spinner, right? So that's why it said generating. I'm going to do a call to this model. So I pass the model in, pass my account ID, and I pass the prompt in. So this again is the prompt that I'm passing, and what I'm passing to the model, the model name here is coming from this select box, and I chose this Dream Shaper, which is a stable diffusion based thing. So that's what I did for that. And then also I created the additional prompt instruction. So again, very similar, just making an API call here to the prompt model that's coming across. And I said, you're a stable diffusion prompt engineer. The user is going to give you a prompt and you will provide three detailed suggestions. And that's what happened. And use various photo stylistic terms. So you can make that really nice. And what I like about this is you're kind of using it to educate yourself about what's possible, about what you could say. And it follows a very similar thing. If you've done any AI engineer work in the past, this is what it looks like. You pass in a messages. You do that, I'm passing in that system message, and then I'm passing in what the user said. I'm getting it back, and then I'm just writing it out to the screen. And we did all that in 63 lines of code. Isn't that cool? Isn't that so cool? So I wanted you to know that there's a README. I will share a link to this repository where you can do this. You can do this at home. Play with different things. See what it is. I would love for you to do that. I'd love for you to play with this. There's so many use cases that we haven't even come up with yet. It is such a bonkers time to be a builder. Let me know what you end up building, and also let me know how your dates are going. If you end up with a great new profile pic, please let me know. Keep me posted on your journey. We'll see you real soon.